Try it. You're gonna love it.
Mm.
Rolls Royce. Yeah, it's amazing. The guy just parked a Rolls Royce here to have an arepa or maybe an empanada.
Exactly.
He's probably Venezuelan.
What's up, everyone? I hope you're all doing amazing. This is David Hoffman from Davidsbeenhere in downtown Miami, my hometown. I'm here with my father today, and we are gonna show you basically what street food is like in this area. If you guys don't know, downtown Miami is one of the oldest settlements in the city, dating back to like the 1890s when Henry Flagler brought his railway down here. In the past 20 years, we've seen it evolve. Office buildings, lots of condos. So you have Biscayne Boulevard, you have the Miami River, and we have Flagler. Flagler is the main street, Zero Street. So this is where we're gonna eat lots of delicious street food. You know, Latin American, Caribbean, arepa, tequeno, café, pan de bono, pan de queso, right? And if you guys don't know, the CDC updated their guidelines. If you are vaccinated against COVID-19 in the United States, you're allowed to walk outside without a mask. They also recommend that you only interact with others who have been fully vaccinated. But regardless of whether you've been vaccinated or not, it's still recommended to wear a mask indoor public spaces. Remember, it's always better to be safe than sorry. Mask, let's walk.
Let's walk. This is Flagler Street. This divides the north and the south of Miami. It's the center line, right? So what's happening here is that we have a big, big development now. You have all these little strip centers that are being torn down. Lots of little nice restaurants, but all of this is evolving and changing now. It's a transitional area.
So back in like the 90s, this was more of a ghost town. You know, people come here, they work, and they go home. At 5 p.m., there would be no one. Now, it's growing, it's changing. Lots of people living in the area, lots of small restaurants. And as you can see over here, this building, I think, is gonna be torn down soon because everything is closed.
Yeah,
right?
All the stores are closed, total liquidation. Yeah, they're changing
this. Yeah, yeah. This entire block's a huge block. This was the Flagler building right here, but it's gone.
It's big redevelopment going on in this area. Hey David, look what I found, Venezuelan place. It looks great. Let's try it. You want to eat an arepa?
What do they have?
Oh, they have empanadas, they have tequeños, they have, I don't know, they have probably different kinds of empanadas.
Carne mechada con queso amarillo.
Okay, y la...
La reina pepiada es...
I'm getting the reina pepiada. That's the real Venezuelan arepa.
No, pollo.
Okay, repollo, pollo. El pollo.
So what are you getting? What are you getting?
I'm probably getting a peluda or a reina pepiada, one of those.
Okay.
¿Qué más tiene? ¿Jamón y queso?
Sí, tenemos jamón y queso. Tengo queso guayanés, queso telita.
So this place is called El Sitio, so Venezuelan food. We have tequeño, which is basically a big cheese stick, right? And then this is
the ham and cheese empanada.
The empanada is a little different, right? It's not like your Argentine or your Cuban or your samosa from India. It's a little different. So it's made also from corn, right? And then over here we have some of the sauce. So this is like
picante. It's like
is it picante? It's
a little bit of picante.
Let's do it. Let's do it, Dad.
Let's do it.
Take a bite of yours. Let's
okay.
go.
Cheers.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Hot.
Mm.
A lot of filling.
Oh man, the cheese here oozing out.
Mm. It's good, no?
Stuff. Yeah, so the tequeño, if you guys haven't had tequeño before, very typical Venezuelan thing, only in Venezuela. My dad, when he goes to like weddings and stuff, he would have like a million of them. They're amazing. This one's huge. There's like a mega one. You know, usually they're small, and you have like five or six. And then here, cheese de empanada, wow, look at that. So you have, it almost looks like an omelet, ham and cheese omelet inside. So it's more like a ham and cheese, I guess, revuelto, no?
Yeah, it's like a huevo revuelto, it's like a...
Like a scramble?
Mm-hmm. People say that these are like cheese fingers, like mozzarella.
Mm-hmm.
It's so distant from the truth. This is not close to a cheese finger with mozzarella. The white cheese in here is so unique. It's so good. It's a bit salty, very smooth. And the outside, it's not, you know, it's like a phyllo though.
Yeah,
you know, it's a phyllo.
Yeah. By the way, I love the arepa, and so different from the other arepas here in Miami. Because, not arepa, sorry, empanada, because the corn dough, it makes it. Mm. It almost feels like cornbread with the ham and cheese mash. Mm.
Let me try this.
Let me get some too. Here.
Okay.
Right in there.
Okay.
So you're back to Venezuela? Mi patria. I know we're not supposed to be eating all the food, but
No, we're not, but it's too good to let it go, right?
Oh man, I love this. This empanada?
What a way to start your Friday, huh?
And the corn dough, it feels almost like the cachapa. Similar, just with the filling. Oh.
It is fried though.
It's not fried fried.
Like
slightly.
Slightly fried.
Oh.
Let's finish it.
And this is La Reina Pepiada Arepa Venezuelan style. So corn dough, they put it on the griddle, they heat it up, then they cut it open, take out all the super hot dough from the inside, and then they stuff it. This one's stuffed with chicken salad, mayo, and avocado.
That is
and
correct.
And this is like what your average citizen eats in Venezuela.
That is correct. Here it's like $7. It's an amazing meal. But over there, it's like less than a dollar. Today, maybe 50 cents. Your average Venezuelan eats this for lunch every day, and this is their one big meal of the day.
And that's it. Okay?
That's it. Heavenly, right?
It's so good.
Let's see.
So filling. So to be honest, this should be the last thing we're eating because of how big it is. It's delicious though, you know?
I would not.
A little sweet?
I mean, that would continue.
You'd continue, I know. I mean, I'm gonna take it easy with this. And what I do is I put this sauce, but if you want to, you can also get this one. What's this one?
Okay. This is like a sauce made out of mayo and garlic.
Okay.
So let's try this. Try it. You're gonna love it.
Rolls Royce.
Yeah, it's amazing. The guy just parked a Rolls Royce here to have an arepa or maybe an empanada.
Exactly.
He's probably Venezuelan.
Yeah, it's too good to leave, so I'm gonna get a little more. A little more.
It's too good to leave, right? It's just an amazing meal.
Can't stop with the spice, and this is like real spice. This is picante, picante. All right, last bite.
David, you're skinny, but I don't know where you put all this food, man. By the way, what better way to do real estate, guys? Imagine. I mean, I do real estate every day in this town. You have these kind of foods. You have, I mean, Rolls Royce shows up.
The contrast, a little, right?
Yeah, the contrast.
This place you eat for like $5. Not really, I mean, like $10. And you have guys in Rolls Royce showing up. All right, I think we need a coffee next. Let's go. So we spent $13, two for the tequeno, four for the empanada, and seven for the arepa. It's a little expensive, but obviously we're in the downtown area.
Yeah.
This is something, somebody's gonna come, grab a quick breakfast, and keep going to the office. Now let's make our way down Flagler. Let's see if we can find a place that has coffee. And maybe some Caribbean food, I don't know.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Cuban coffee. So here, David, we have the Alfred Dupont building, which used to be a bank, as you can see the entrance. And inside, it still has all the decor of the bank. It's got this beautiful ballroom on the top where you do weddings. I've been to many weddings here. Amazing place.
And that's across the street from the Olympia Theater, which is the oldest theater in the area. I actually did my high school graduation right there. Okay. Everything's closed here. This is crazy. It's empty.
Nobody here.
So we're passing now the Siebel building, which is like the jewelry building. That's where you come to buy watches, you know, diamonds, gold. Outside, as you can see, it's like all the shops are closed, but this place is more like an interior mall. Everything's inside.
Right.
I mean, this area around here just looks dead right now. I've never seen it this dead.
It's incredible. I mean, I've been coming here for ages, and yes, I mean, downtown has always, you know, hasn't been like the big boom place. But there's always people. Now it's like dead. It's incredible. Okay, so what do you want, David? You want colada or you want cafe cubano?
I think we should split a colada and maybe an egg sandwich. Egg, bacon, and cheese sandwich. See? Yeah.
Suizo, no?
Suizo. So we came to this place called Atlantis Cafe. So this is more like a Cuban mom and pop hole in the wall. You can see their menus right here, obviously COVID times. It's a window, la ventanita. You come here, you get your coffee, you can get colada, cafe, cortadito, or cafe con leche. We always get the colada because we love it. And here they have huge menu, right? We're going with a breakfast sandwich, very easy.
David, I'm gonna show you a trick how you pour this because most people don't know how to do it. You create like an angle here.
Here.
Eh?
What is the shot to you?
Second. Yeah, we took it for you in a single.
Okay.
Cheers. Mm. This is like the best coffee, far above anything else you drink out there.
I think my dad likes the sugar.
Love it.
Oh man, it's good.
Very good. It's very good. This coffee mm-hmm. is very good.
And they give you little cups, so you split it. So usually people get the cola, they go to their office, and then everybody shares. So it's like $2, like $1.50, right? $1.50. Very, very affordable. You have like three or four of these, and you're electric.
Let's see this amazing breakfast. Let's see what they did for us here. Okay. Whoa. Okay. Look at this. Look at this. The sounds of downtown. Okay. So this is, we have this amazing breakfast sandwich, Cuban bread, pressed. It's a egg, actually it's not scrambled, it's like fried. And the cost of this is $4.50, that's it.
Mmm. Good? Mm.
Okay, so this sandwich is definitely better, fried egg than scrambled. The scramble would just fall out. This is like perfect, it's folded, it's amazing.
My turn, guys. Woo. Incredible sandwich. So what cheese is this?
Swiss cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Is it good or what?
And the cheese.
It's oozy.
Mm-hmm. Come. Mm. I love these sandwiches. I love the bread, the way they put it on the presser. You got some bacon, you got cheese, you have the, so it's not scrambled egg, it's basically just a fried egg mixed, right?
Comes out better if it's scrambled, it just falls apart from your sandwich, right?
Mm-hmm.
It stays in. And look at this bacon.
Let's finish this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this.
So good.
Mm-hmm. I wasn't gonna finish it, but I can't not finish it.
Not leaving anything. Unfortunately, everything's falling out. And this is probably one of my favorite Cuban breakfast sandwiches. Hmm.
It is definitely on the top, I mean, right there.
And why is it Cuban? Because the bread.
And the people.
Yeah, and mix it with the coffee. I have like cheese all over my hand. Are you full?
Pretty much. But let's try one more thing.
We have to try one more thing, and here we have a street food hot dog vendor. Look at this. So if you want, just like New York, hot dogs on the street. I actually right. never see them, but they're usually next to the courthouse, and the courthouse is like right over here somewhere, right? ¿Qué tal, todo bien?
You know, it gives me great hope always to see people like that with it. The hot dog cart is the entrepreneurial spirit of America. It's always there, always. You never cease to see this.
We just passed Flagler. We're going south towards the Miami River, and we're passing by the Macy's building. Well, this was the Macy's building, now it's Ross. It's a huge city block, and this eventually will be redeveloped like every single block here in downtown.
Everything. Actually, we're in the middle of a boom. Who would have thought that in the middle of a pandemic, we're having a huge real estate boom. We have a lot of people coming in from New York, from Chicago, from Los Angeles, from California.
Exactly.
And everybody is coming to Miami. It's incredible. Everybody's selling in here.
Now, where are we going? There is another hole in the wall around here. I know a Cuban place I really wanted to go to. Or a Brazilian place, no? Pão de queijo. O pão de bono. Our next stop is Papito's Cafe. This is like a more of a real Cuban ventanita, right?
Yeah,
so
right.
They have the empanadas, they have the pastelitos, they have croquetas. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna go a little more healthy.
It's a healthy version.
We're gonna go the healthier version. We're gonna get a shake here. So they have some fruit juices, right? 16 ounce, 12 ounce, and 32 ounce. I just need a small one, a 16 ounce.
Yeah, we'll get a mixed one.
So it's $3 for one of these. Look right here, they have.
Yeah.
Hola, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás?
Buenas.
¿Cómo estás?
¿Qué tal?
Muy bien, ¿tú?
Ah, bien, todo bien.
Listo.
¿Y el nene dónde está?
Mezclado.
Este vale $3.
$3.
Claro, usted para él, 2.99.
Ah, no, fabuloso.
2.99.
No, no, demasiado. Sí, sí, no. dame uno.
¿Tú quieres uno también? Ok, dale.
¿Cuál quieres?
No sé.
Mira, aquí hay mora, McBerry, guaramelo, Papaya.
Papaya, papaya. Muy amable.
Ya.
This guy's too nice. Too nice. So I got papaya.
De viejo, ¿no?
Demasiado.
Una vez en cuando. Gracias.
Gracias, amigo. Gracias.
Okay, this is like a mixed fruit smoothie. And it's an all natural fruit. $3. Only $3, guys. So fresh, so refreshing.
So I got the papaya, straight papaya. He got only berries.
I got the mix.
Wow, what delicious smoothie. So it's not like a real milkshake. This is straight fruit. So whatever you want, right? So they have it right in front. They have all these like mixed fruit salads right there. You choose, and he'll make it for you if he doesn't have it ready.
They don't add any sugar to it whatsoever. It's all natural. Whatever sugar there is in the fruit, that's what you get.
Mm-hmm. Incredible. With this heat in Miami, right now it's like 11 in the morning, super hot, 90 degrees.
Probably in the 90 degrees.
I think so. It's scorching right now. Oh, lleno. Me llené, amigo. Amigo, gracias.
Gracias,
muy amable, muy amable.
Hasta luego.
Muy bueno.
Los dos. YouTube y Instagram. YouTube better. Cuídate, hasta luego. Nos vemos. All right, now we're going to the mouth of the Miami River, and we're gonna give you a super surprise experience right now. Yeah, did you?
Ese es su pai.
Sí, mi padre.
Papá.
Mi papá.
Brasil?
Brasileiro.
No, I live here.
So you saw my video in Brazil? Yeah. Which one? Curitiba?
Curitiba, São Paulo.
You saw.
Você comeu muito pastel? Pastel.
Pastel grande.
Okay, David, so now we're going to the Aston Martin building, which is the only Aston Martin building in the world. And it's right here, and then it's the Epic Hotel and Towers next door with the Zuma restaurant on bottom. JW Marriott is across the street. And then we have Met3 here, which is a rental building, but it's a luxury rental building with a movie theater chain inside. Plus, there's an Indian burial from the Tequesta Indians who inhabited this area before.
So this street, Southwest 3rd Avenue and 4th Street, is the intersection of these four towers. I remember when this was empty, there was nothing here. Now you have basically life. You have one of the best restaurants in the world right there, Zuma. We have here, you know, JW Marriott. And if you wanna go to the movie theaters, you can go right there. So this is probably the best place to live in downtown. And we're gonna go up hard hat tour right now to the very top of the building. I think we're going to the 54th level. I think there's over 60 floors. We'll learn more about it right now when we enter. Wow, look at this Aston Martin. So which one is this? Do you know?
No?
It says it on the back. So yeah, it's not the DBA or DB9. What is this? This is the Rapide.
Rapide.
Let's see what's inside. Come. Look at this.
What?
This is an Aston Martin Vulcan, and I think they made very few in the world. You get this when you buy the penthouse here, which is about, I think close to 60 mil. But this is a $1 million car.
There's your incentive. Spend 60 million, you get 1 million free. And a very exclusive item. Look at this car. This is ridiculous, Dad. I mean, you can't even drive us in the street.
You can, of course, in Miami. Why not? Look at this. This is the machine.
All right, I want that car.
Why not, right? So Natalie, how are you?
Very good, Thomas. Good to be here.
Thank you. Natalie is the in-house specialist for Aston Martin. She helps me out with my clients. Tell us a little bit about Aston Martin.
So this is the first one and only Aston Martin ultra-luxury residences in the world, located in the heart of Miami, in the middle of the city, with the last land with water views. 66 floors, 391 residences. Now I'm gonna show you the views. Come with us.
Okay, because we're going up. It's a hard hat tour. Can I get your hard hat?
Hey, Harold.
Let's get this.
You have socks?
We need socks. We need socks for sure.
This is like you're gonna jump off a plane with a parachute.
It's not getting really ready. Parachute, Dad.
I know, but a light parachute.
So you guys, there's a twist.
Yeah, there's a twist.
We are ready to go. Let's go up.
There we go. We're making our way up. Love this. Hard hat tours. Been in so many. This is going to be exciting. The view from here is going to be epic, right over the Miami River.
incredible.
We're going to the 48th floor to see the east views. It's 180 degrees of unobstructed views.
It's actually really scary.
It's so pretty on the water. Here looks so small when you go up. It's gigantic. It's water everywhere.
We gotta go.
All right, here we go. 48th floor. This is awesome. Oh my gosh. Incredible. That way, that way. From the 48th floor, we see over all of Key Biscayne. We see over Brickell Key. That is Brickell Key right in front of us. Carbonell, Asia. Over here, we have Icon Brickell. I mean, this is an incredible view. I can't wait to see the other side, looking over downtown. You clear every single building from this level. It's over 500 feet high.
So this is a 01 line. It's the unit 4801 is the signature residence, meaning once you purchase this residence, you also get a limited series edition of either the DB11 or the DBX. The limited series is going to be called the Miami Riverwalk Edition, and there's going to be only 47 of those cars. So come and get one.
This is a dream unit, 4801. I mean, the views from here are incredible. Unobstructed views overlooking the Biscayne Bay. You have Brickell Key right there, so you will never have a building obstruct your view because they already built out most of that island. Over here we have the Port of Miami, and this is all downtown. As you can see, I mean, the views are endless. I mean, just incredible. 180 degree views overlooking all of Miami, Florida. Man, this elevator is a little scary. It's some scary stuff, dude.
Hey,
oh, you have vertigo?
I have vertigo. Yeah. And it's not like this. It's like you feel like you want to jump out. It's terrible. If you feel vertigo.
Yeah, that's also suicide, Dad.
Yeah, vertigo's very good. Suicidal vertigo. I understand how you feel. I know exactly.
This is scary. Double tap. Bam, bam. Thanks, guys. Thank you. Hard hat tour of the Aston Martin residence is over. That was epic. Going to the 48th floor. That's what $5.5 million gets you in Miami.
Obrigado.
Muito obrigado. Prazer, David. Finalmente.
This is Paulista. Santos. No, I'm Flamengo.
Tricolor, tricolor.
Let's jump in the car and let me take you down Biscayne Boulevard to show you what's really happened here in the last 10 years, which has been an explosion. So Biscayne Boulevard is a mentor of her right in front of the water. We have here Bayside, and we have here also the American Airlines Arena, AAA, where the Miami Heat play. And there's a number of residential buildings which are immensely, immensely beautiful. The view here is breathtaking. We're gonna show you some of it.
You know, when the crash hit 2008, we built basically Miami. We built over 100 towers in that time. And over here we have the row. So it's like 900 Biscayne, 10 Museum Park. And we also have 1000 Museum, which was built by the late Zaha Hadid. It was her first Western Hemisphere tower. And I think Beckham lives there now. It is like a work of art. It's a one of a kind masterpiece building. And then behind it, we have the area which is called Miami World Center, which is an up and coming area. We have Paramount, which is the main building there, but it's like 20 other buildings being built there. A mix of apartment buildings, which are like rental buildings. Then you have condos, you have office buildings, and we also have the Waldorf Astoria, which is being built right here on 300 Biscayne, which is like a super tall tower, over 1,000 feet high, and it's like cubes.
There's construction all over the place here. We're building a new city here. It's incredible, everywhere you look.
And right in front of us, we have the Brightline Station. That is the high-speed rail that will connect Miami with Orlando in 2024, they're saying now.
Legacy, incredibly, is sold out in the middle of the pandemic.
So that is Legacy Tower. And then over here, they're gonna build another tower called 11. So that is a club over here, but you know, they're doing so well, they're building a tower.
It's a party building.
And that is our street food tour of downtown Miami. That's what street food's like here. Small hole in the walls. You have a huge mix of Latin American cuisine. We found a Venezuelan place. We had tequeno, empanada, arepa, super delicious, really filling. After that, we found another small hole in the wall, which was a Cuban place. And we had a breakfast Cuban sandwich, you know, like Cuban bread, toasted, you know, flattened, pressed, and a colada, epic. And then we found another place, that has some shakes, right? So fruit shakes, super, you know, delicious for this weather, fresh. You know, it's really hot, Miami, you need that. And then after all that walking, we went up to the top of the Aston Martin Residences, the 48th floor, $5.5 million unit. What an incredible view. I mean, that's what's happening here in Miami. We're getting some of the most luxurious towers. You know, all the big name brands are bringing their towers to Miami, and that's downtown Miami. It doesn't stop changing, it keeps evolving, and literally they're gonna keep building Miami until there's not one piece of land left from Brickell all the way to Midtown. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Leave me a comment below, subscribe to my channel for more awesome travel content. We'll see you in the next travel food adventure in
Miami.